All right. I want to say it's an honor for me to be able to read the induction memo here of Mr. Peluso into the honored American, Italian-American group. So it's well deserved. So it is an honor for me personally as well. Jerry Rex Peluso was born on December the 8th, 1958, to James Peluso Sr. and Della Frances Smith Peluso. He is the grandson of Giovanni Peluso and Antoinette Schiavo Peluso, who emigrated from the province of Salerno, the region of Campania. They arrived in America on June the 11th, 1910, on the ship Batavia. Jerry has four siblings: James Peluso Jr., Sherry Costello, Angie Peluso, and the late Joanne Truesdell. He attended St. Stephen's School in Newport and Newport Catholic High School. Jerry has a large family here tonight up on the stage. Jerry's nieces include Vicky Peluso, Stephanie Steffen, Amanda McFarland, and Alicia Peluso. His nephews are Brian and Chris Truesdell. He has many great nieces: Megan Millard, Isabel Steffen, Mara McFarland, and Elle Wilmot, and a one great nephew, Dominic Millard. Jerry has worked in the retail business for almost 45 years. He has made many friends while happily employed with Market Square, Liberals, Thoroughfare Markets, IGA, Remke Market, and Fresh Time. He now operates the family business, Peluso's Market, circa 1931, for his mother, along with his two sisters, Sherry and Angie. They continue the family tradition of selling Christmas candies, spring flowers, and vegetables for the planting season. Over the years, his community service includes serving on many boards and committees. He is the co-founder of our annual Newport Italian Fest and has served on the Newport City Commission for 34 years, including 12 years as mayor. Jerry is currently the city's longest elected official in its 227-year history. Quite a feat. He's taken a brief reprieve over the next few years, but he will stay involved in the city without a doubt. His interests and passions are many: helping our senior citizens, working with others, and keeping our city as safe and clean as it can be. Many times you'll see Jerry out on Mama Street picking litter or sweeping up litter on almost daily basis, as well as tending to the flower pots along Mama Street. Although he has a secret for his own pot, I noticed, that he doesn't share. Thoroughbred horse racing, baseball, bowling — he has a 300 ring, by the way, for bowling — and traveling and sightseeing. Things you may know or may not know about Jerry — I didn't know a lot of these. He still has his very first car. He bought in 1975, a red 1967 Le Mans Pontiac convertible. It's a really nice car. He has a pet bird, Peaches, who is 32 years old. So that's quite amazing in itself. He enjoys cooking his favorite food, Brasciole, which is stuffed Italian steak. His favorite shows are Westerns and anything from the 1970s. Jerry is also known as Cheyenne, and the name Jerry isn't on the birth certificate. I'm about to find out why that is. Kind of curious. He has several words of wisdom, but these are two of them that are his favorites. Number one, it's not about the amount of money you make in life. It's about how you're going to spend it that matters. And the second one, as your precious parents get older, love them, honor them, and always take care of them. It is an honor for the City of Newport Italian Fest Committee of 2022 to present Jerry Rex Peluso with the honored Italian American Sons and Daughters Award.
Tom, thank you very much. And I also want to thank the Italian Fest Committee for this very special night. And I would be remiss if I didn't thank all the individuals for the last 30 years to help put the Italian Fest on. Thank you very much.
Amen.
You know, this recognition is very appreciated and very humbling. But it's really about two other people that really started it all. My grandparents, Giovanni and Antoinette Chavo Peluso. And I'm gonna try to paint a picture, tell the story of those two individuals, my grandparents, that lived here in the United States for 57 years. They both came to the United States in 1910. They brought with them four children, Vito, Helen, Frankie, and Carmen. Like many other European immigrants, they came to the United States for opportunity and a better life. They brought with them their culture, traditions, and family values. From 1910 to 1931, my grandparents were farmers in the community called Bellefonte, Pennsylvania, a small town outside of Penn State University. During their time there, the family grew. Joe, Lucille, Lena, Dewey, Margie, Ernie, Jimmy, and Johnny were added to the family. In 1931, Giovanni and Antoinette and 10 of their children moved to Newport, with the exception of their oldest, Vito, who stayed in Pennsylvania, and Frankie, who was tragically killed riding a motorcycle in Pennsylvania. That same year, my grandfather opened his first business, a produce market at 712 Mama Street. It was a one building with three storefronts. It's the same location where the former state theater was and now a city public parking lot. Soon after, my grandparents moved their business to 623 Mama Street, where it is today. In addition to fresh produce, they sold imported bulk pastas, olive oil, cheeses, and many other Italian foods. After World War II, two of my uncles, Joe and Ernie, along with their wives, and my parents, James and Della Francis, who were newlyweds, moved to the state of Washington. While living there, my grandfather, Giovanni, was in a horrible accident on the 12th Street Bridge between Newport and Covington, involved in a Green Line bus that put him in a hospital for many months. When news of the father's accident reached the three sons living in Washington, my parents, James and Francis, took the long drive back to Newport and eventually took over the family business. When Giovanni and Antoinette came to America, they brought with them their family values. When they became U.S. citizens, they took on American values. Because of their hard work, their love of God and country, and a love for their children, they left a very successful legacy. In closing, I want to say that last week I was at the Hopper House celebrating German Day weekend, and this weekend it's the Italian Fest. Events like this are very important to me and should be very important to everybody else. It's important for people here in the United States. They celebrate and they live their grandparents, their great-grandparents, their traditions, and their cultures, what they brought from other countries. Whether you're from Italy, Germany, France, Ireland, it's important that we continue to celebrate those traditions and their cultures. Today in America, things are becoming all the same. You look around, the cars look alike. The buildings look alike. A lot of the music, it all sounds the same. So it's so different, it's so important that we can keep those traditions alive. I want to thank everybody for sharing your time with me tonight. It really means a lot to me, and I want to thank all my family and my cousins that's out in the audience. And I want to thank my grandparents, because we're here because of them. Thank you very much.
Having known Jerry Peluso for the last 20 years, I can tell you there are no words on a page that can truly describe the authenticity, the integrity, the honesty of this man. I love him dearly. Let's hear it for Jerry Peluso.
Amen.
Woohoo!
Woohoo! Wanted to take time before the band comes on to tell you about our sponsors and folks. God bless you all for being here. But I want to mention our sponsors because, again, they're so important, so integral to what happens here every weekend. Of course, in memory of Griffin and Anna Carlisle, Capital Investment Group, the Townsend Company, Cold Iron Concessions, Newport on the Levee, Ovation Corporex, Keating Moving, and Click Clamp PLL, Newport Clifton Development, Rumpke, the gold sponsors, Riverfront Place, Pompilio's Prime Ale, the silver sponsors, Seco Electric, Victoria Square Apartments, the bronze sponsors, the man that we just honored, Jerry Peluso, BB Riverboats, Assured Partners, IBEW Local Union 212, MC Steel, Monmouth Row Apartments, the Frommy Family, Tom and Jenny Gaduli, who are here with us, Steve and Pam Crawford, Strategic Advisors. Let's have a round of applause for all of our sponsors.
Amen.
The 2022 Newport Italian Fest. Vinyl Countdown is coming up in a few minutes. Again, thank you for being here. It's my honor, and I'm humbled by the opportunity. We'll see you throughout the weekend.
Was my song okay?
Yes. Get Debbie, let me get you. Now, hang on just a second here. Okay. Now, tell me who you are.
Debbie Peluso.
And
Jim Peluso.
And they wanted to say hello to you, hon, and they're going to be saying some prayers for you tomorrow.
Best wishes. You. Miss you.
And
good luck tomorrow.
Yes, say prayers.
And she's the smartest move I ever made.
You'll be okay. You're a smart girl.
God bless you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you.